This podcast is brought to you by Most Valuable Podcasts, saving your day from boredom with the best podcasting entertainment.
What's up, what's up, everybody? Ricky Widmer here, along with fellow man-child, Johnny Karlic.
Hoo-wee!
And we are back for another edition of the Rick and Johnny Podcast right here on Most Valuable Podcast, one-stop shop for entertainment news, for superheroes, comic books. Really, I think the catchphrase that we're going with is anything That's under the nerdy suns is what we are going to hit here on the Rick and Johnny Podcast. Got a jam-packed show, as always, going to be looking at the new Venom trailer as that came out. It's funny because we recorded last week, last Sunday.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, Tom Hardy says they're going to put out a new trailer at CinemaCon. That next day, boom, new Venom trailer. So I'm like, well, we got to wait a week before we can talk about that. Mm-hmm. Then we're going to be looking at an Avengers topic for what the title of Avengers 4 can be. I will say right now that will contain Infinity War spoilers. And then the last segment, we're going to look at a possible Man of Steel 2 movie for DC and what we want that story to be. But Johnny, let's jump in.
There's a lot of pauses.
We've got Venom, the new trailer, and basically the question that I think is most important to this trailer. Did they get Venom right? Did they?
Did they?
I'm asking you.
Oh, you're asking me.
Yeah, I'm asking you. Oh, that's right. I'm asking you.
Well, it's the thing you're asking them. I mean, they're the ones that this is they're more important.
We always ask them. Their opinion is the most important. But I'm asking you for discussion. Did they get Venom right in this trailer? Because this is the first time we've seen it.
No, I love it. I love what they did with Venom. I'm actually watching the trailer over and over again, just so you and I have referenced throughout this thing. And no, I really like what they did with it. I mean, I wish we had a little bit more story because looks like there's more than one person being infected with a symbiote or symbiote.
I'm gonna get into that.
I wanted to get you.
I'm gonna get
that
into
right
that
now.
In a little bit, but I mean, we kind of knew there'd be more than one symbiote, because of the storylines, the lethal protector and planet of the symbiotes that we knew they were going to kind of combine together. But this is one where, I mean, I look back and I had to look back at the Sam Raimi Spider-Mans because that was the last time we've seen Venom.
I had to double check on those too, just to remember what it looked like.
It wasn't terrible. Like, I look back and maybe this is me kind of being an apologist, but I'm like, it doesn't look bad, but this one looks a lot better.
Oh, completely agree.
Like, it looks 10 times better. The thing that I like the most is it seems like he's not going to have the white spider on the front.
Yeah.
Because realistically, why would a symbiote have the spider on the front without knowing who Spider-Man is?
Exactly. So I like that they're going with that so far. I like how the that was weird. I like how it doesn't have the whatchamacallit from the Sam Raimi ones where it has like the webbing design. Again, same thing. Why would it have that if it doesn't know Spider-Man is necessarily? I just like a lot of the things about it. Well, for one, when you finally see in spoilers, if for some reason you haven't seen the trailer by now,
Will be down below in the description.
Yeah, so where it actually forms over, you start seeing the teeth
form. Yeah, it goes around Eddie Brock's head.
Yes, it goes around his head. The white eyes form, though. Mm-hmm. And then you get to actually hear the voice of it more so than, like, the whispers in his head.
Yeah, that the only We are Venom.
Yes.
The only
I almost
thing,
said Groot.
The only thing I will say I don't like yet about it is the eyes seem like it just seems weird to me. Like, looking at the eyes right now, like I'm looking at a picture of it. I don't know if it's because of like how it looks, but it looks like a glob of like glue to me.
Yeah.
And like, of course we know like at this point, maybe all these special effects aren't done yet. So I'm not saying, oh, it looks terrible, write it off. But like, that's the only thing I would nitpick with it, where somebody creatively did something where as Venom came up and around Eddie Brock, there was like, boom, googly eyes on Venom.
That's what it
looks like. Yeah. But I mean, everything else from the way the tongue moves to the teeth, it's like, holy shit, that's Venom.
Yeah, and I mean, maybe the eyes will look better, like you said. Maybe it's not done in post-production. Maybe there's more that's going to be done with it. I'm not completely opposed to the eyes, though. Maybe as we see it moving around, it'll make more sense why they did it in that fashion. My thing, too, is not just him in the symbiote suit. I love it, by the way, again. But, like, him outside of it with working with the symbiote, though, like...
The voice sounds like Venom, too.
Yes, the voice does.
And the voice that I'm using as a reference that I think you are, too,
yeah.
is the one from, like, the Spider-Man 90s cartoon. Spider-Man yeah. cartoon.
Where it's kind of a triple-tone voice. It's, yes. Almost whisper in your head style until it actually talks. Well,
this one is just like a deeper voice, and we don't know who's actually voicing the Venom character yet, but it was like hearing that deep voice, I'm like, oh my God, it sounds like the Venom voice.
We are Venom.
Yeah, it sounds like that voice that I remember hearing way back when I was a kid.
Yes. No, that's what it reminds me of. I think that's the nostalgia they're probably trying to hit. Cause
yeah.
Who's really
going to drive to these movies? The other thing that I kind of liked with the whole Venom thing about it is when the kind of the Eddie Brock Venom give and take.
Yeah.
Where Eddie Brock is like, all right, we're going to do this, but you can only, like, you're not going to hurt anybody.
As I see it, we can do whatever we want.
Exactly. And that's when he pushes him against the wall. And Eddie tries to get, like, move that hand forward, but then it was like, boom.
Yeah.
Against the wall. Basically saying, hey, man. I have control of you.
Yeah.
I have infected you, and I can make you do whatever I want.
Well, the one thing I do like, too, and it's interesting to see, is he's got to be new to the symbiote, like almost like he doesn't realize it's there exactly yet, is when he is in his apartment and three guys come up to attack him. Well, you got...
Because they're from the Life Foundation.
Yeah, and hey, it's like, they want their stuff our back. Property back. And all of a sudden, you just holds up with a neck via... symbiote punches a guy with like a symbiote arm. Mm-hmm. The one other guy tries to come in the room out of his back and just bam.
That was the best one.
Yes.
Where just he like, goes to shoot at him straight out of the back against the wall. And then he just jumps out of the window.
Yep.
And the other cool thing I like, and I've seen some people complain about this, but I kind of liked it from the trailer. He's riding the bike, right? Mm-hmm. And then he does the jump and the bike like goes away. And it's like, oh shit. And then the symbiote comes out of his chest, grabs the bike, and pulls him back onto it.
Yeah, or generally same scene where he's riding, the cars are chasing him down, just takes two cars, throws them sideways, and gives the other two cars something to crash into. Mm-hmm.
And I mean,
it's trying to protect it. It's a parasite in a sense.
It's trying to protect its host. Thank you.
I was trying to remember the word.
And I mean, the thing that we also see is we saw... two other of the symbiotes. Not exactly sure which ones there's going to be.
Yeah.
There was the one character that was kind of latched up on the board with the thing around his face.
Actually, I think it was around his chest because he's screaming in pain.
Then there was the girl on the ground that was kind of like shaking, moving her head and stuff. She was the one that jumped out of the cage and kind of attacked Eddie Brock.
I don't know if it's Eddie Brock because it's not really clear.
It is.
Is it?
The reason why I say that is the whole... theme they were kind of putting off is that he was going to sneak in to find out more about it.
Yeah.
And then that's where he found that. That's how I'm assuming he gets infected. Is
true,
she tackles him, a little bit of that symbiote
comes off,
goes on to his person.
Onto him, yeah.
And
that makes sense.
The thing is, we kind of know much about a lot more about the story now is that he's a reporter, obviously. It's Eddie Brock. There to report on the Life Foundation, because he's there doing an interview.
And he's like,
everything seems fine. Then he asks a question, and they go, fuck it, interview's over.
Yeah, it's kind of an incriminating question.
Yeah,
that's why.
And I mean, then at that point, he sneaks in, boom, then everything with the Venom symbiote.
That makes sense.
I want to ask you, seeing this trailer, does this change anything or give you a better idea of what we talked about, I think, a week or two ago? With the whole Carnage situation, now that we know a little bit better how Eddie Brock gets the symbiote and exactly what's going on a little bit better with the Venom symbiote.
You know what? I think...
How I'm saying symbiote.
Yeah.
Symbiote.
It's not symbiote?
It's not symbiote.
Are you sure?
God, I hope they fix that. If they don't fix that, let's put it this way. This is how much I'm going to hate that. If this movie ends up being a 5 out of 5, but they say symbiote for the whole thing, it's a 4. I will take off a point in my review.
A full point, not a even like a point. Point five.
Oh, I'll take off. If you want a point five, let's go point five. I will take off at least a full point for that because I'm that upset about it.
No, I'm asking you if it wouldn't even just be like maybe 0.5 because she can't pronounce it, right?
No, it's a full point.
Wow. Okay.
Because you as the director should know how it's pronounced.
Very true. Very true.
That is how upset. That's the only thing I hated Ricky's about this trailer. This. Is it symbiote, not symbiote? But well, I'm a perfectionist. Go ahead.
Hopefully she fixes that then.
Well, they fix it. Yeah.
They. The only thing I'm interested in now is there's the capsule. Not the capsule itself, but the whole ship. I'm trying to decipher. Is that parachute? Like parachute string coming out of it, or is that webbing? Because we have hints that Tom Holland's supposed to be in here, right?
Yes, but I think it's supposed to be like cameo-esque ish.
Yeah. Well, I mean, could that be a Spider-Man cameo? I'm not saying Spider-Man's gonna be in there, but
well, here's what I'm thinking. And this is why I'm glad you brought Spider-Man into it.
Yes.
I heard this actually, I heard it, and I'm like, great. Like that is. I could see that being the case for this movie.
Mm-hmm.
I think they're going to have Tom Holland in it, kind of like how Captain America was in Spider-Man Homecoming.
Very true.
Where Eddie Brock will be walking past some, like, because people are like, oh, when's he going to get the white spider thing on his Venom suit? What I think is going to happen is when he's infected with the symbiote, we're going to see on the TV something about Spider-Man. Or in general, basically, it's just going to be Spider-Man on the TV.
Yeah.
And the symbiote's going to see the spider emblem in the middle and go, that's a cool idea. And then kind of adapt that into
the suit.
The symbiote. Yeah. Yeah. To make it look cool. That'd be cool.
Like after credit scene style thing or something.
Even,
or
very even end. If it's in the movie, like at some point.
I just think that if they're going to do an after credit scene thing, that'd be a nice.
Because I think the after credit scene nice would throw be. In. The after credit scene would be
the
Carnage
thing.
Yeah. If you haven't introduced Carnage to that point.
Yeah. I would go with that then. Mm-hmm. Have him do it like at the very end of the movie. That mm-hmm. way, like, he's in the symbiote, looks in like a Spider-Man, like from the Infinity Wars. Mm-hmm. And I'm the only reason I can say this isn't a spoiler because you've seen it in the credits.
Yeah.
You saw it at the end of Spider-Man Homecoming.
Mm-hmm.
The new suit.
The Iron Spider suit.
Iron Spider suit, yeah. That spider, tell me that doesn't look like the same as the symbiote one. Different color, but
yeah.
The way it lays across the body mm-hmm. looks the same as the symbiote one.
No, yeah, and that's what I'm thinking.
He sees that one and
he sees it, but the symbiote's the one that goes, oh, that's cool, and kind
well,
of
him or the
it.
Symbiote sees
yeah,
it.
Or either
like,
or.
I mean, either way, it's probably both.
Mm-hmm.
Because we are...
No, this one...
We are Venom.
This movie is very... Like, this was one where I was kind of on the same boat as Dave,
mm-hmm.
where it was like, you know what? I'm not super hyped for this one. Like, I'm going to go see it. It's Venom. I love Spider-Man. He's my favorite Marvel hero, but... I'm not expecting this to be good. This trailer came out, and I'm like, I cannot wait to see
Same.
This.
I am so excited now because
like,
of it.
My hype level just, boom, went through the roof and just kept going and going to where, what, at the trailer, the one that's down below in the description, ever from, let's see, the timestamp I would start at would be about 2:18, where the guy comes up and he goes, who are you? And then the symbiote grabs him and goes, we are Venom.
Yeah,
and then it's basically, hey, I'm going to attack you, which they set that up for that line because they wanted the we are Venom to end it. But seeing the symbiote at the end of this trailer was perfect.
Yeah.
It was perfect. Loved the symbiote costume. Like I said, the only thing I hated from this trailer was how they pronounced symbiote.
And there's only one person that's screwing that up so far.
Well, and the thing that I hate most about it
mm-hmm.
is that's the only time they said the word in the entire trailer. So it's like, is she just saying it that way? Is that how they're going to pronounce it? Someone please tell them that's not how we pronounce it kind of a
nope,
thing.
It's
like,
not.
And that's my biggest worry right now. And I know some people might be sitting there, Ricky, that's a silly thing to be worried about. But it is. It would kind of be, I'm trying to think of an example. If like let's say it was like a Batman movie and they, instead of saying Bruce Wayne, they wanted to say Bruce Wan instead of Bruce Wayne. And they
That'd
wanted to
weird.
Mispronounce a name differently. It'd be like, no, that's not how it is. And that's what I feel like with the symbiote
like
thing.
Mispronouncing vibranium or adamantium.
Yes, exactly. That's probably a better example.
Yeah. But
I was just trying to think of something off the top of my head. Any final thoughts with this before we move on?
No, I'm excited to see it. I mean, I'm not as perfectionist as you, so the symbiote, as long as she's the only one.
It just sounded so
As long as she's
off.
The only one mispronouncing it, I'm not going to really harp on it. If they're all mispronouncing it, then yeah, I may take some points off of
but
that.
But at this point, like some, I said, she's points. The only one we've heard say it. So
yeah,
we
that's
don't
very
know.
True. So, I mean, we'll have to wait and see, but that's the only thing that's like, as long as she's the only one mispronouncing it, I can let it go, but get a voice actor then?
Mm-hmm.
Or not a voice actor, but a
voice coach.
Voice coach, someone that can teach you how to pronounce it properly.
Symbiote.
Symbiote.
It just sounds so weird, like symbiote. It's like no, it's symbiote. But this is where we're gonna turn it on to you guys. Let us know what you guys think of the new Venom trailer down below. In the comment section, you like it, you love it, you want some more of it, or did you hate it? Did you absolutely hate it and you don't think Venom looks right, and what would you do differently? Let us know what you guys think down below in the comment section.